All right, y'all. You see this platter full of zucchini, corn, peppers, onions, peaches, pineapple, mushrooms, onions. And we have steak and we have sausage, potatoes, radishes. And we're going to take all of this today and we're going to make our kabob. Today is Friday, air fryer Friday. Every Friday we do something in the air fryer. Today I'm using my countertop air fryer and I'm using my Ninja air fryer right here. So stay tuned. Come to Grandma Rose's Open Pantry on YouTube and see how we're going to make this delicious kabob.
We're kabobbing, aren't we?
We are. Air fryer Friday, y'all. And look who I got in the kitchen with me.
You know how I'm in this video today. Several of y'all mentioned that y'all enjoyed seeing us together. And she said, well, a few people out there seem to like you. Maybe I ought to use you in the videos more. And so that's the only way now. That's
really
the only way I got in.
I needed help today. That's what it was.
She wants my hands. It would be all right if I weren't in it, if I just used my hands.
Today is Air Fryer Friday. We've got two air fryers. We've got my countertop one over here, and we've got my little Ninja. So I have got, look at this platter. Can you see that? It is peaches, pineapple, corn, zucchini, onions, mushrooms.
Now, they don't make a 6-foot kabob.
No, they don't.
So all of that won't go on one kabob.
And we have got sausage, we've got little red potatoes, we've got radishes, and we have got some sirloin steak. Now, this is what we're going to be making. We're going to be making kabobs today. Now, that's the reason I wanted Roy to help me, is because I get confused when I start doing a whole bunch of stuff together. He's here to keep me straight today.
You got to be kidding.
What?
Me? Keep her straight?
And we went ahead and cut up all of our veggies because, and I'll show you, you just cut them in the size pieces, whatever size pieces you want. That's your peppers and my zucchini. And then your mushrooms, I just slice my mushrooms like this.
I cut the corn.
Yep. And the pineapple, just pieces the size that you can put on your kabob. Whatever, how much you want on yours. Now, if you're doing this in the grill, these kabobs were like this long. I mean, these skewers were like this long. So you can do the whole skewer. But since it's going in the air fryer, we were limited to how long our skewer could be.
And you can involve the children and let them make their own kabob out of whatever they want off the tray, because all of it won't go on.
Yeah, I wish Kale was here or Promise and they could help me. But what I'm doing, I've got a piece of sirloin steak here and I'm gonna come up closer and I'm gonna show you. This is the size, just the size to go on my kabob. And I'm gonna season my sirloin steak. Now we've got smoked sausage that they have cheese in them. So I'm not gonna season those, but I do want to season my steak so it won't be bland. And I have put salt, pepper, and Italian seasoning on my mushrooms and my zucchini.
Because they are bland.
They're bland.
The rest of everything on the table has a nice flavor, from your onions to your peaches.
Yep.
Did you tell them we had peaches on there?
Probably. I don't know, honey. I was trying to name over everything. So
I'll show you. Oh, I love peaches. These are crisp, but they have a delicious taste. You can use plums.
You can use plums, nectarines. I do have pineapple. Pineapple, peaches. Whatever fruit, or you don't have to put fruit, use whatever veggies you like on yours. This is just what I had, and I said, you know what, we'll just, and they're not going to all be made the same. They're all going to be made different. Let me wash my hands.
It's hard for me not to start eating all this stuff.
I know. All right, now. This is our steak. let me get my tongs because I washed my hands and I don't want to touch it again. Of course, we're going to be touching it the whole time. Would you get me that seasoning over there and the olive oil?
Okay.
Yep. All right. Now, this is a really, really good seasoning. It's called the perfect seasoning. It is made with garlic, onions, let's see, it's garlic, onions, and something else, parsley. So I'm just going to sprinkle some of this on my steak. And I'm going to use olive oil to...
sort of make it clean?
Yeah, mm-hmm. And I'm gonna spray my veggies in my steak with olive oil, because you know when you put things in the air fryer, you spray them with the oil. So now that's a fatty piece. I'm not gonna keep that one. All right, honey. Now I have soaked my little skewers in water for like several hours.
That's to prevent fires.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now on the grill, soak them overnight, pretty much. But now we're just gonna do this. I made out a list of what goes what, but that's too confusing. So there's your skewer, and I'm gonna let you you can either use steak, you can use sausage.
And if you don't cut up this many options, it's easy to
Oh yeah, this is just what,
five or six pieces. Then you
this
just,
is just things I wanted to show
okay.
y'all. Now I'm gonna do steak.
You wanna?
So I'm gonna put a piece of steak on
well,
mine.
Well, I'll start with a sausage.
All right. I'm going to put a pepper on mine, like this. Then I'm gonna put a piece of pineapple. Then I'm gonna put a piece of onion. Now, like I say, you use whatever veggies, whatever fruits, anything that you want. All right, now it's going a piece of corn. Now, you want plenty of meat on it. So, I'm going to put another piece of steak.
Mushroom.
Piece of zucchini. Mine is going to be so different from Roy's.
I want y'all to look how easy this goes through the corn once you have pierced it with a
with a pitchfork, with an ice pick. With an ice pick. Okay, I put that one on wrong. I need to put it on like this.
I better put another piece of sausage on here.
Yeah. Nope, that's wrong too.
Pepper.
Y'all, you gotta learn how to do this. All right, there we go.
Well, this is my first
time. No, I'm gonna do it like this. Now then. I have to get it on there so I can get more. All right, I'm going to put another piece of steak. Oh, I'm going to put a potato
Some
on this
purple
one.
Purple onion.
And I'm going to put, I've got corn. I'm going to put another pepper.
Another sausage.
And I'm going to put a pineapple.
And pineapple.
And another piece of steak. Okay. So on this, I've got four pieces of steak.
Now, you have to leave enough room at the end.
That you can, yeah.
But you don't have to have extra room. Just
That's right. All right. And as we get them made.
Are these the one that go in here? Okay.
Uh-huh, I think so. Yeah. I'm not sure. Now, this one goes in the air fryer. These are... I had to make the ones that go in this air fryer a little shorter. Yeah.
Is this one going in the air fryer?
Uh-huh, that one. I don't think this one will. I think this one will go down here. No? Mm-mm. It went in. All right, I'm only going to be able to get three.
You need the two shortest ones.
Yeah. I'm only going to be able to get three in this air fryer. So,
okay.
All right. I'm doing steak. I'll put a mushroom on this one. Because steak and mushrooms go well together.
Sausage. I'm gonna put a potato on first.
Pineapple? That ain't pineapple, that's pepper. All right, a peach.
Sausage.
Okay. Another piece of steak.
Pepper.
Y'all, this is fun. get your
kids
children,
would have
get your children in, and
well, even the guests, if they wanted to make their
this
own.
This is fun. It's like a fondue, you know, where you have everything cut up and you have your little pot of oil and you put it on a skewer and you bake your own or you fry your own. So
what is a fondue?
Fondue. Yeah. Uh-huh. That's from way back in the 70s. Yours, did it come apart?
Okay. My mushrooms, the plumas did.
Oh. Yeah, mine tried to earlier.
Yeah.
All right.
Get another piece.
Now, I'm putting several pieces of steak on this one. Because this is for meat eaters right here. All right. And I'm going to put a... another piece of pepper and another piece of steak.
Peach.
All right. See that?
Onion. Potato.
All right. Roy and I are going to keep making our kabobs, and when we start to put them in our air fryer, we'll be right back. All right, y'all. We have made our kabobs. And we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 on here. And we got 3 in this air fryer right here. And I've got a 4th one, so I'm just going to lay it on top of these. And halfway through my frying, then I will switch it out. So, all right.
But if you needed to, they would cook layered in air fryer because the air is circulating.
Now, my potatoes and my radishes, because it takes them so long to cook, this other is probably going to be 10 minutes, maybe 12. But I pre-cooked, I steamed my radishes and my potatoes in my microwave steamer. So what I'm doing, I'm just going to, Roy's got me some paper towels here. Pick that up for me, baby. Okay. Because I'm going to put olive oil. There we go. I'm going to put olive oil on these. And then I'm going to put some salt and pepper and some seasoning on them. I'm going to put some of this complete seasoning. All right.
You mean to roll them?
Yes. Wait, let me put a little salt on them and a little pepper.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to sprinkle a little salt because you do want to season them. You don't want bland kabobs. All right?
No, I really think this is a family gathering.
It
thing.
Is. It's
for
wonderful.
For the children and the adults, too.
Okay, can you turn them over?
It's called not cook your own, but fix your own.
Yeah, this will really be fun, y'all. It's just something I thought Roy and I would enjoy getting in here doing today. And I said, you know what? I bet a lot of y'all would enjoy it, too. So, and like I say, put whatever you want on yours, mix and match any way you want. And if you just want steak and potato, just put steak, piece of steak, piece of potato, piece of steak, piece of potato. I mean, that's just, all right, I'm going to flip these over. Just ever how you want to make yours. There are a lot of meat potato people out there, so. All right. Okay. But be sure you season them well. All right, a little salt. A little bit more salt. Now, you always want to put olive oil because olive oil will make your seasoning stick, and when you put them in the air fryer, that air is dry. So this olive oil keeps them from being so dry. All right. This one is going in this air fryer. I'm going to put it on, 360 degrees, and I'm going to start out with 10 minutes, and we're going to see how long it takes. All right, this one over here is going in. Can they see me, baby?
If I move.
Over here. All right, I've got it on air fryer. And I'm going to put it now. In this one, air fryer is it's a set 425 degrees. But 425 degrees in this one is not as hot as 400, 400 degrees in that one. That's the reason I put that one on 360. So I put this on 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, I'll check it out. We're always fixing to wash all these dishes, so.
Wait a minute. I'm one of the main stars now. I don't wash the dishes.
So.
And you can put all these, season them and with oil and pepper and different things, mm-hmm. and slide them in the oven on a tray, and it's delicious too.
Be delicious. So, all right, let's get all this cleaned up, and we're gonna check on our kabobs in a minute. We'll do that.
What is that song? Traveling along, kabobbing along, side by side.
That's right.
She actually won a 4-H club contest, her and her best friend.
When I was in eighth grade, we won second place in the state by singing. We dressed up like hobos, and we sung, this was in the late 50s, and we sung that song side by side.
And guess who she beat out, who was also singing? Wah. Isn't that terrible to be beaten out by your wife?
This is just a little something y'all didn't know about us, so see y'all in a minute. I want y'all to look at these. Wow.
The top one cooked just as well as the ones on
yes,
the bottom.
Yes, it did. Look at that. All right. Now, let me just tell y'all what I have discovered. That air fryer, it said in the book that it cooked on air fry at 425 degrees and you could not reset it. Well, I put my oven thermometer in there and it's cooking at 300 degrees. This one cooked at 360 and it is done 10 minutes before that one is. So, I almost gave this one away when I bought that one, but I am so glad I didn't.
Well, this one probably is just defective.
It may be.
Thermostat.
It may be. The thermostat may be. But yeah. I still use it for a small oven. I use it to toast. I use it for a lot of things. So
you just know it takes a little longer.
Yeah. And I'll just use this one when I'm in a hurry and want to air fry. And if I'm not in a hurry, I'll use that one. Okay. This is the one in my Ninja air fryer. Doesn't that look good? All right. And the other one likes about 5 minutes. So we'll be back in about 5 minutes and show you what they all look like. Okay, y'all. This is our kabobs, our air fryer kabobs right here. Air fryer Friday kabobs. I want y'all to look at that. I'm not gonna put those two on it because I don't want to crowd my plate. But y'all look at this. Now you talk about something that's gonna be delicious. And look at all those colors. And your air fryer, it keeps your color. It doesn't, like if you do it in the oven or something, your colors fade, but your colors are so vibrant in this. So,
and it gives it sort of a grilled all the way around texture.
Yeah.
And this air fryer got up to 350.
50.
Might have gotten higher if we'd left it longer, but
yeah.
So it took about 6 or 7 more minutes to cook in it,
didn't it? Honey, never mind. All right. Roy and I are going to taste of it for you. Let's see. This one is a sausage one. This one is a steak one. All right. Which one you want?
I'll do the sausage.
We do both.
I cooked it.
Okay. We do both. All right. Now, it's hot, baby. It's hot. It's real hot.
That corn is good.
That steak
is
perfect. Taste that steak. That steak is cooked perfectly.
Wow. This is good.
Isn't that good? I'm not going to eat them.
The radish is good.
That steak is just falling all to pieces.
You have to bite it over a plate because when it falls off.
Let me get pepper.
Sausage. This is delicious.
We're hungry too.
I don't have to be hungry to eat your food, baby.
All right, y'all. Make you some kebabs. Make them any way you want them. If you just want meat and potato, put steak potato, steak potato, steak potato. But this is just a really, really good way. If you don't want to go outside and grill, do it in the air fryer.
Fruit's good on it, too.
Is it? I didn't get a piece of fruit, but I'll get one in a minute. All right. I hope y'all enjoyed Air Fryer Friday. Roy and I loved doing this. And so we're probably going to do some more things together on Fridays for Air Fryer Friday. Love y'all. Food feeds the family. Family feeds the heart. God feeds the soul. Put deliciousness back in healthy food.
And if I build a little fan base out there among you, she'll let me on this side more. But she's not willing to start washing the dishes just because she's sharing airtime with me, I'm telling you.
Oh, that corn. That corn's delicious.
Love y'all. Y'all have a wonderful day. This is low carb eating in the quantities of the corn and, say, the pineapple. You're not eating much of that at all, so it's still a low carb load. Glycemic load is what we're talking about.
You don't make this one, you're missing something.
Right.
And once you get everything cut up, and you don't have to do as much as I did, which I just wanted to show y'all the variety that you could use. But you can, goodness, it takes what, 10, 12? It took 12 minutes in this air fryer and like 18 minutes in that air fryer. So once you get everything cut up, good grief, you can have these done in 30 minutes. So, love y'all. See you next time.
Thank y'all.
Okay. Grandmama, that looks so good. Wow. Look at that, folks.
Kabobs.
Kabobs.
Done in the air fryer.
Hey, and a bright kabob to you all.